Do you ever feel a jolt of electricity when a singer nails a high note? This weird sensation goes by many names. Some call it frisson. Others say the chills. But most of the time, people just call it goosebumps. It feels a lot like a small shock, because it actually is. When you hear something that takes your breath away, your brain releases several powerful chemicals. They increase your heart rate, raise your temperature, and make your skin more conductive to electricity. So, when your nervous system sends out an electric signal, it stimulates tiny muscles at the base of each hair on your skin. This is what gives it that bumpy look. Most of the time, goosebumps aren't a good thing. You get them when you're scared, stressed, or cold. But musical goosebumps come directly from your emotions. When something amazes or moves you, your nervous system starts sending out electrical signals. Your hair stands on end because you're invested in the music. Why do we fall in love with music? We've all listened to the same song on repeat. We've all drummed or sung along as loud as we could. Music makes us feel energetic, powerful, and inspired. But why? A study from 2017 found that your favorite songs activate the same part of the brain as many addictive substances. The knack is your brain's main pleasure center, so it controls motivation, rewards, and reinforcement learning. Think way back to elementary school. When you got a good grade on a test, what's the first thing you did? You probably went and told your parents. You knew that they'd be proud of you, which told your knack to pump your body full of feel-good hormones like dopamine. Turns out your favorite songs do the same thing. In 2012, researchers found that listening to music while eating or drinking can enhance the taste. Cognitive priming works the same way for your taste buds. If you hear a mellow song, then drink chamomile tea, your drink will seem more relaxing. The music primes your brain to feel a specific thing, so your food will taste better when the flavor matches the atmosphere. Now, of course, that means the opposite is true too. If you drink your tea with heavy metal blasting in the background, well, you won't feel nearly as relaxed.
Be careful, young lady, what you let yourself listen to. Be careful, young man, what you allow in your earbuds.
We are in control because basically we are not a political organization, we are an occult organization. We're working behind the scenes to manipulate the way that people think. The war that we are waging is a guerrilla war on the human mind. And we use musical frequencies, the dominant frequency, which I've referred to before, and symbolism and imagery to awaken dormant aspects of the human mind. And symbolism and imagery to awaken dormant aspects of the human mind. What we're waging is a cultural war right now on every front, in music, in literature, utilizing the media against itself. We're using music because that's the instrument that young people respond to right now.
I figured out that hertz is to understand the frequency vibration, right? So there's kilohertz. Well, sorry, there's hertz, kilohertz, megahertz, right? And then I think it's ultrahertz. If I play with those frequencies, right, I can target certain parts of the mind, target the frequency to go to certain parts of the mind, and I can literally, like, if I want you to astral project, right? You know what astral projection is?
Yeah.
If I want you to astral project, or if I want you to go to sleep, or if I want you to go into a meditative state, I can make my music do that.
The agendas of this world have been able to come to this point of climax simply because the population of this world are dumbed down and don't really understand the real way this world works. But I will not just let the enemy run over the minds of the population without trying to wake them up. This world is not one big gray area where things are not very clear. This world is broken down very plainly. What happens in your life is all about choice. There are two paths that you can walk on, and you can only choose one. Before the world changes and resets, and the test that is coming really starts, I'm going to tell you the unedited truth about the world that you live in. Let's begin. So let's start with the most common misconception and work our way back out of it. Like my friend was saying, he believes everything that is happening is all about money. The mandates are all about big pharma getting richer. And basically, this is what moves the world. It's all about a motive of accumulating more wealth. Again, that is a lie. Or maybe lie is the wrong word. It is a distraction that those with power want you to believe so you're not able to truly see what is driving and moving this world. Let's be clear. The reason why so many people are able to believe that money is the main motivation for all the systems being built up in this world is because money is the biggest motivation for themselves. Money is one of the first tools used when people are recruited into this system. And in the beginning, for most, money is what drives them. So they believe that the rest of the world is just like them. And guess what? That is probably true. But that is not the way the real world actually works. Do you know what the biggest fraternity in the world is? Do you know what organization consists of the most members in this world that also contains most of what we deem as the rich and successful people in this world? From world leaders, to business leaders, to religious leaders, entertainment leaders, social activists, etc., etc. That fraternity and organization is Freemasonry, secret society. But I'm going to use one of the symbols to explain how the world really works, because their beliefs are the underlying foundation of how the world system has been built. So using their way, you should look at the world not as a division simply between the rich and the poor. That will never help you understand. You can't even divide it by the rich, the middle class, and the poor. This again is still too small of thinking. You must view the world through their structure of a pyramid. This is a pyramid. You see, the base is very large, and as you go up the pyramid to get to the top, it gets smaller and smaller. If you were to fill it with people, you would see that at the base of the pyramid, you can fill it with the most people. And as you move up the pyramid, the amount of people in it gets smaller each level you go up. This is exactly how the world works, and you will not understand anything unless you understand that. And as you go up different levels, there are different motivators that move this world. When you get to the very top, it is easy to see that money is not even a thought, and it is at the top of the pyramid where all the decisions about this world are made. So let's go back to the point about money being the main motivator. This is the level of thinking that is at the bottom of the pyramid. That is because they are the ones without it, and therefore believe that obtaining it will make their lives better. And so the majority at the base of this pyramid commit their lives to moving up to a higher level within this pyramid, thinking it's all about money. But let's just review these levels in the pyramid, because this is where so much of the confusion is. How most people want to look at this pyramid is that at the next level is where we have the enforcers of the system, like the police, the IRS, etc. And then after that, the wealthy. But the levels do not move up because of positions or wealth. People move up in the pyramid by knowledge and initiation. But again, as you move up in the hierarchy in the pyramid, the amount of people in each level decreases, and along with money being their motivation. In school, we were taught that the President of the United States is a position that is at the top of the pyramid. But that is just not true. Maybe this was true when the position first came in the beginning of this American experiment. And more than likely, that wasn't even true. But that certainly is not the truth of today. The truth is that being president doesn't even mean that you're at a high level in the pyramid. I really want you to think about it. What do you even see a president do? They read speeches. They give interviews. They take photos with world leaders. But you never actually see them leading. You may see this in the movies, but you never see this in reality. You just see a position. What we see is a person who we believe has a high-level position. We see them reading speeches, giving already prepared remarks. You think that press conferences are real? That they are answering questions that they aren't already prepared to answer? No.
I'll take your questions, and as usual, folks, they gave me a list of the people I'm going to call on.
They know the questions that they are going to be asked before they are asked. They take their orders from those at the top of the pyramid, just like the other leaders in the rest of the world. When they carry out their orders, it just trickles down within the system for compliance. If you think the President of the United States is the most powerful person in the world, your reality is not real. The people actually pulling the strings, making the rules, are people you never know that live behind the curtains. Very much like a producer of a news program or television show. You know the actors, the news anchors, but you don't know who it is that is speaking to them in their earpiece, guiding what they say and who to go next to. What to say, when to cut the feed. The people you are watching are not in control. They are script readers. What I'm trying to explain is that the reality that people want to believe in is not real. It's an illusion to keep you sedated and not able to see the real puppet masters. In the 19th century, they were already in control of the world. That's 200 years ago at least. This is the old money that has been passed down through the centuries. They used their power to build the world. They started the first multinational corporations that started employing the world. They are at the top of the pyramid. I want you to really think about this. You have heard of the Rockefellers, the Rothschilds, the Morgans, the Vanderbilts, the Lees, but this knowledge of them was from the 19th century into the early 20th century. After the Great Depression, their influence became hidden and they became the unseen hands of the world. They are almost at the top of the pyramid and they gained control of all industries in this world through their control of money. By controlling the money and who had access to it, it was then easy to yield their influence. They built massive corporations and funneled their money between them all. They take seats in corporations as board of directors, never being seen, while yielding their influence with assurance. So for instance, when the pandemic started, the new rules were synchronized. All of a sudden, all of the world were following these new rules that came from the top. It's because they're at the top of these companies. There is not a part of this world that is not controlled by them. They created the television, which needs to be broken down by itself, because the television is the biggest weapon in history ever used against humanity. It is a mind-controlling device that is able to hypnotize the watchers and feed them with the thoughts and feelings that they want you to feel. And it went from having one in each home to now everyone in the world walking around with one in the palm of their hands. They created news channels to feed you with the information they want you to know, making you feel informed. They created the sports and music and food channels or whatever else to keep you sedated and asleep while they continuously move in with their agendas. That's why what we watch on television is called a program. There are different programs for all the different types of people, but it is all used to move humanity in the direction that they want you to go. It's not about money. If they already control it. It's not about power. Through their control of money, land, and resources, they already have the power and they yield it in the way they desire to steer the world. It's not about control, because again, they already have it. This whole matrix is one big illusion given to people without control by the small amount of people with control. This is the truth about this world, and this is where people can't fathom and understand. At the very top of this pyramid is not men. It's Lucifer. You think that's crazy? It's not. It's right on the back of the United States dollar bill. The Eye of Providence is the Eye of Lucifer. And the people at the top of the pyramid take orders from him in order to create a world where he will be worshipped as God. At the top of the pyramid below Lucifer are people helping to fulfill a goal that was attempted at the Tower of Babel. A world government where all people work together to challenge the God of heaven. Everything in life today is all about religion, but the truth is masqueraded by different distractions and illusions that hide the true fact that the true leaders of this world are creating a world where Lucifer will be worshipped as God and his son will be worshipped as a Messiah, the savior of the world. This is not about the United States. It's about the entire world, which is why everything we see today is all global. The majority of the countries in the world are under the same program and mind control because the world is being unified and put together so that the world could worship Lucifer and call him God. Lucifer will be like the Most High. That is what everything in this world is about. It's all about religion, while they make you hate religion at the same time. It's ironic because people that hate religion, which may be you, is just another part of their control because they confused everything. They put money and hypocrites in the leading role of religion, decreased faith tremendously, perverted the word, created divisions and denominations, placed in man-made traditions and doctrines. It created false churches that then created false followers that believe they are following the God of the Bible when they actually don't know what and who they are following. There is a massive perversion of the truth, so that now it is diluted and edited that the masses cannot identify it. The reality of the situation is that the world is being unified to accept a world religion, which places all religions under the same category, so that everyone believes they are worshiping the same God. The world is being put together under the same rules and laws, so that there will be one dominating voice that leads all into submission to the rule of Lucifer. World government, world currency, and world religion are the three main goals of their new world, that once it is fully formed, the world will be under a completely satanic ruled government. And those at the top of the pyramid are those that worship Lucifer and have been tasked with creating this world. You see, if it was all about control and power, they could have created this world 100 years ago if they wanted to. Because minus the technology, their power was intact. What we have been going through for 100 years, through the past four generations or so, is a mental conditioning of humanity that has slowly been introduced to satanic principles, and now they accept them. Understand, the devil doesn't need to come in his name, and he doesn't care what name you call him. There is no power in his name. His power is through lies and deception. He is the author of confusion. He hasn't just been working just to get the masses just to praise him. He has been working the masses to accept his ways and doctrines. He desires to make evil good and good evil. He intends to disrupt and pervert all of our Creator's ways so that it is his way that is worshipped and followed. Now, is that really that hard to believe? If you look at the world and what it accepted just 20 years ago to what it accepts today, it is completely upside down. The values that the whole world once held onto is completely looked at as outdated and oppressive. That is because Satan is working to defeat the Most High's influence on earth. What is the Illuminati? It's about enlightenment, the enlightened ones. What is the goal of Freemasonry? To spread light around the world. These are simple facts that a simple Google search can provide. But what you don't realize is that it's the light of Lucifer that this light represents. That's who the Statue of Liberty represents. That's what the torch held high in Colombia represents. I mean, that's why it's called the District of Columbia. They're spreading his light. The world has been prepared to accept the light of Lucifer, and it is at this time that the world now accepts it. Lucifer means light bearer. He bears light. It's a false light, though. All the music you hear, all the television and movies you see, are all small little sermons spreading that light. Most of the music we listen to is actually religious music that is masked as simply secular.
Hail Mary to the city, you're a virgin, and Jesus can't save you, life starts when the church in.
That's why the guy Lil Nas X, an extremely untalented individual, is a star. He is a tool, and is celebrated for it, because he has allowed himself to be used to successfully show that Satan is in the midst of everything, and the people show that they don't care enough to change their ways. This year, he was a part of a satanic sneaker, and he made a video giving Satan a lap dance. But you want to think that what I'm saying is far-fetched? Here's more of the truth. Everyone that says they are a Christian and a believer in the Bible, but then tells you this is just unfounded conspiracy, is an ultimate tool of Satan, knowingly or unknowingly. They don't believe the Bible that they say they believe in, because here is what is remarkable. This is all written. The Bible literally has foretold of all of this and has told us of what is to come. And those that tell you that this is a conspiracy are either hypocrites that don't really believe in what they say they do, or they're just followers who follow the church and its culture, or they are sold out to Satan and cover themselves in the disguise of Christianity. I mean, look, the term Christianity is a man-made thing altogether. That is a label created by the world, by the same system that controls the world today. Whether you call yourself a Christian or not is irrelevant. It's about your fruit, not about the label. People are so distracted by titles and labels.
My favorite Bible verse, because I am Christian.
They don't see what is hidden under the cover. It's like this guy, being able to call himself a Christian. Nowhere does he match what we find in the Bible in reference to what is righteous. But because of the times that we are in this world, no one can tell the difference. The unedited truth is that if you have been following this world, being moved by an attachment to it, being moved by fear of losing access to it, being moved by confusion, being moved by a belief that you can do what you want and God will accept it, you are a Satanist and you probably are unaware of it. What is Satanism? It's not worshiping the devil. No, it's doing what you want. It's about rebelling from the ways of our Creator. And most of you live in a mindset where this is okay and it is acceptable. Most of you want to believe that all you need to do is be a good person and you will be accepted. But the question is, who is defining what is good? The same people that poison your food, spread cancer through your bodies, bomb countries, displace nations, create war and genocide, are the same people that later on donate to organizations to feed the poor and heal the sick in their hospitals. Do their rights outweigh all their wrongs? Good is subjective to how you want to look at it, or who you normally compare yourself to. The truth is that you are being walked into a path that leads straight to hell, and the devil wants you distracted from it. But here's what's next. This current world system will collapse very soon. All the ways of this world you are trying to protect yourself from will all be gone. Your job, gone. Your money, gone. Your neighborhoods, gone. Your way of life, gone. Now that the hearts and minds of the world are converted, the world is going to be reset into something new, where those at the top of the food chain can retire and allow Satan to fully take over. The world will be about preparing for battle against the Most High. Life will be defined by your choice to either accept Satan and his world system or not and follow the Most High, and then by consequence lose access to the world system. You see people being trained up and conditioned for that today. Everyone right now that has been forced to take their solution to this pandemic has already made their pledges to this new world order, which will give them access to the system. That is why your job, your healthcare, your travel, your entrance to events, etc. is all tied into it. It's all about the new world that is being created, and you can only have access to it if you have conformed. Okay, now I spent the last 30 minutes giving a very quick overview of a very difficult topic to understand. But I have not yet covered the most important point, and I want to cover it because this is the reason I made this video. It wasn't to scare you. You may see all this and feel there is no hope. Most people I have ever discussed this with like to back away from discussing this part of the topic because, like I said earlier, they are cowards and they feel there is no hope. But that is not the truth whatsoever. We have an ultimate hope, but you have to choose. Do not serve God and Satan. That needs to be clear. There are only two sides in this battle. That is the side of the Most High or the side of the created being, Lucifer. This is a battle for your soul. You think you can control your own mind? No, they're already working on hardware that can read your thoughts. You think you lack privacy now? Thanks to blockchain and digital currencies, there will not be one activity that you do that the system will not know about.
Every time you use your face to unlock your smartphone, accept Facebook's photo tagging suggestions, or sort through a Google Photos album by person, you're seeing facial recognition at work. Huh. Whether you're tagging photos or searching through a vast government database, it's the same technology at work. Clearview AI is a huge player in this space. Founded in 2017, Clearview has amassed a database of over 3 billion images.
The Toronto Police Service has made a disturbing admission. Officers use secret facial recognition technology from Clearview AI to dig up sensitive personal information. They were ordered to stop using the controversial tool last week, but just last month, the police denied using it at all.
The facial recognition software attempts to match people's faces with billions of images scraped off social media websites.
Be careful, because you don't know what music does to you psychologically as it plays. We just think it's music, but no. Let me just say this to you. Music is the only element on the planet that was not made on the planet. Music is the only thing in the earth that wasn't made in the earth. Music was made in heaven. Wasn't made here. Everything else that we do and manipulate is all earth made, all earth formed. Everything you see was made here. The lights, the sheetrock. Everything you see was made here. Music wasn't made here. It was made on a different level, a different plane. And so it operates on a different plane. And guess who made music? Not the devil. If you say the devil, I'm going to be mad at you. The devil did not make music. There's no such thing as devil's music. Okay? The devil didn't make music. He was put over in charge of it. But he didn't make it. God made music. And do you know why he made music? So God forms the most powerful element on the planet just about in music. And God gives it one strategic design. One. Music only has one function. And I don't care what degree you have or what theological thought you have right now. It's wrong. And I'm right. Music only has one function, and that is worship. 100%. Oh, no, Brother Chavis, I just like the beat. No. It's impossible. It's impossible. Listen to me. It is scientifically impossible to only listen to the beat. You ingest the words. And we wonder why we keep having teenage girls get pregnant, and all they do is listen to songs about fornication. And if I was your girlfriend and I got your man, and we wonder why we can't get behind the preacher when he preaches, is because you've allowed the world to preach to you through your earbuds for 30 hours this week. And you expect the preacher to get through to you in an hour? The problem is we're spending more time worshiping the devil and his thoughts and ideas and plans. And we've worshiped the culture all week long through our iPods and our iPhones and our iTunes. And we've worshiped and worshiped and worshiped. And then we come in here and we sing songs about Christ. And we can't lift our hands. We're wondering, why can't I have freedom of worship? Because you've given out all of your worship. You worshiped all week long. I didn't worship. I'm not worried. Yes, you are. You're sitting in your car driving, bobbing your head. Oh, what is it? This is worship. And they know it. That's why Jay-Z starts his concerts by saying, put your hands up. I'm the J to the H to the O to the B to the A. Jehovah. He calls himself Jehovah. And he says, put your hands up. And they do it. Worship. Worship, worship. When you hear the sound of music, you bow down. We got young men and young ladies that don't know what to do with the emotions, the natural hormones that are flowing in your body just naturally. But then you're going to listen to music about love and sex and drug abuse and treating women so poorly and listen to all that mess and then come into the house of God and wonder why you can't find freedom and wonder why you can't stop looking at pornography and wonder why you can't stop living how you're living. The devil is a lie. Turn the music off and you won't bow. Get you some Jesus music and worship him all week long. There's some good music out there. Listen to songs about uplifting God. Listen to songs about living for Jesus. Listen to songs about doctrine. Listen to songs about the oneness. Listen to songs that uplift Christ. And you'll find out that you have more peace and you have more favor than you ever had before. Turn off the music. Let me just stop right here and say this. The devil has always used music as a cue to bow.
Sometime after Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego began to serve in the court of King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon, the king had a golden statue of himself made. The massive 90-foot-tall statue stood as a monument to Nebuchadnezzar's power and greatness. The king ordered all the leaders of Babylon to come together for the dedication of the enormous idol. On the day of the dedication ceremony, all the leaders of Babylon gathered by the golden statue of King Nebuchadnezzar. A herald announced to the crowd that they were to bow down and worship the statue when the music began. Anyone who did not do as commanded would be thrown into a furnace of fire. So when the sound of music from the trumpets, harps, flutes, bagpipes, and all sorts of instruments was heard, everyone bowed down before the statue. Everyone, that is. Except for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
If at first the idea is not absurd, then there's no hope for it. Albert Einstein. People of the world, welcome to the giant. The visitor attraction for the 21st century. The exhibition space featuring the giant experience, a glorious celebration of the great men and women of your country, inventors, artists, scientists, celebrities, and athletes. The viewing tower. See the city from the shoulders of a giant. The roof garden. New dimensions in retail, gastronomy, and special events for diversity of occasions. The world's tallest moving sculpture. Its head moves. Its arms move. It speaks and sings. A place to behold heroes and superheroes. A place to celebrate the great and the good, the game changers, the icons of your city and country. Every hour, the giant transforms into an extraordinary person, from sports, science, characters, your favorite heroes, and recites poetry and words of wisdom to the crowds below. A space to celebrate the great and the good. The great men and women who have made this world a better place to live in. A digital canvas for artistic creation. A creative canvas like no other. A digital art gallery in the sky that displays masterpieces from today and throughout the ages. The giant brings artists together from throughout the world. A beacon for brand celebration. A new eye-catching platform for businesses to reach customers in a novel and memorable way. A giant opportunity. A business model that delivers world-class experiences and world-class profits. An economic stimulator that enhances tourism, job creation, footfall, and commercial activity in the city. Join the Giants movement. The world's largest selfie. An homage to human potential. The world's most awe-inspiring selfie. Visitors are scanned and instantly become a giant. An experience to share and remember for a lifetime. There's nothing like it on the planet. Imagine you can be the giant. The giant transforms into a stage and a backdrop for festivals, concerts, performances, and special events. Let the party begin! Seen further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants. The giant. coming to 21 cities in 2021. Awaken the giant in you.
Before I hand over to you gentlemen, I think the one thing I took out of that is how really advanced we are in technology, in knowledge, but also in deception. There, all I saw there was idolatry, especially with this giant concept. Nowhere for God to be found in that. It's all about self, lovers of self. And it's actually stunning to watch. But Baruch, I'll hand over to you for your comments, first of all.
Well, what spoke to me about that presentation is that so much of it's based upon falsehood, on fantasy, on escaping reality, choosing what we want, the celebrity, the athlete, whoever it is, everything's to our liking. It focuses on man. And as you pointed out, where is God? Where is true worship? And it's all based in corruption, self, pride, and our ability to choose apart from what the Word of God would have us to choose.